Oh, hello and welcome once again. J76NY here. Back with our Confederate forces in June of 1864. Last episode, we did take Fort Johnston over here. We got enough of our forces assembled that we could make an assault on it. So we did that. It was another major victory for us. I'm going to go through real quick. I know some of our forces were pretty weak, so let's see who we can combine. Oh, killed. Let's take these two here. Take a look here, see if we can actually, if we actually have any of these to do. Hundred yard, 3 rounds a minute, your board. 5 at 4. Let's upgrade them to Enfields. Okay. Find you. Anderson. Gonna leave him alone now. Ewell, let's take a look at his first. Doing pretty good. So those are the forces that were involved in the Battle of Fort Johnston. Well, they're not doing bad, I guess. Stuart, real quick, while we're screen. Not doing too bad either. I think that's what I want to do with them. Policies, really need this bounties to come through. 6.2 days. Hopefully we get enough volunteers we can gather in the force here in Virginia. We'll worry about who is going to command that when we can actually do it. 1,000. If these two forces can combine to go up against the 4th Corps, it's going to be fairly even. Ransom coming too, so that should kind of even things out a little bit. And then once this 4th Corps is dealt with, I'm going to send Johnston, or not Johnston, but Stuart Jones. I'm going to send them down to start retaking some of our lost territory in North Carolina. I do know there's another Federal, just this one right here, 2nd Corps, 21,000. We got Lily's Corps here. There's only 8,000. with Lily. He is working on Lasky. Got our force down here in Florida that retook Jacksonville, and the state of Florida, we're sending him up as well. That's another 8,000 men, so it'll give us 16,000. Still going to be outnumbered, but we do have to do something about this guy before he takes Charleston. He's probably on the verge of doing anyway, so there's that. Moving out to the west. Our Navy is just completely inadequate. The only one holding Louisiana is a brigade-sized army. Strength here. I don't know if it'd be even a good idea to send him down. I don't think he would do pretty good down there. We've got these two forces out here in the 19th Corps, 18,000, the Army of the Gulf, 6,000. Vicksburg, that's what I want to get here. We've been trying to cross over here in Vicksburg. Has not gone well. So I think what I'm going to do instead of trying to cross here, I may come up here. Everyone's reading. Come across over here and then come at him from the side. Our Cavalry Corps over here. Encamped. Have him come up here. This area here. Waiting on Hardy. A Hood is okay to go, but they've got a force out here. I have moved Army of the Mississippi up. Cavalry Corps here. I can Twentieth Corps, 19,000. What I really need is more troops for volunteers. We've got over 100,000. Less than they do right now. About the same amount of casualties, but with the deficit in what we have versus what. A little harder for us to do anything about it. I don't think the British are ever gonna come along for a ride. Tons of Union invasions. Blockades are 57% chance at Fort Pulaski, 65% at Fort Jackson, 49% at Fort. So let's see what we can do once the clock starts and go from there. Glorious victory at Fort Jackson. Pickett surrenders. That's something I should care about. I don't think it's our Pickett. Battle of Fort Jackson ended with the Union units retreating in panic, and has earned us a remarkable big victory. Okay, so we captured Fort Jackson. Union units are retreating in panic. Here's Fort Monroe. Nothing much is happening. Kind of holding position right now. We are moving down. Hopefully our cavalry doesn't get down. Okay, well. We are slightly outnumbered, but I'm going to go for it and see how we do. Burkeville, Virginia, June 10th, 1864. It's a meeting engagement. Obviously, I'm going to be waiting for the rest of my troops to get here. Union fields 22,000 men under Major General Howard. Confederacy fields 8,000. Okay, well, not outnumbered. So, Battle of Burkeville, Virginia. A Burkeville, Virginia, inner victory. We are waiting on Jones. Be here in an hour. But for the time being, Stuart, out some scouts. Scouts can come up with. I'm going to hold my guys in position here till we, get the rest of our power. Now, get it? You can go into marching columns. Going to probably move up here. They're meeting and acting on them. Going to be done. And if I had to guess, I'd say they're probably sitting around this area here waiting for it. So we are going to get our scouts. And I'll maybe separate out a vision to go see what they can see. Marching columns. Going to be coming in from down here. I don't want my main body to get too far ahead. Very wooded battlefield, Appomattox, so we can get our artillery up on these hills somehow. they're going to be kind of useless. Our cavalry is moving out, so chances are we aren't going to see them before the end of this day, and then we can redeploy. I will get all that out of the way and get back to you with a hopefully positive report on what we find. All right, everyone's here. Day two has started. This is the Union position here. I'm going to actually gonna redeploy my guys just because I want them in a better position here. Now, I know that's going to make the Union redeploy as well, but heck. Let's get Ransom, put him back in single line. I guess it moved him way up there. Ransom has 7,000. Jones has 13,000. Like, they've probably got everybody they're going to have here. Yeah, they did. Have Jones here. Ransom. I want you here. Cavalry, Stuart. That's the thing, is like they have to go through woods. It's going to take them a while. I don't know if I want to put them up here. Put them down here. Might have a better chance with our artillery if we come at them down here, but they are in this area still. A little bit of an incline here. Got detachments out front of their lines. Bring our cavalry. I think our scouts are actually out. Got some detachments here. Max, I'm going to call in your scouts. These scouts down here, what I could do with them is I could bring them around and bring the cavalry around in this direction, try and come at them from this side. Last time Stuart did a charge, it was unintentional on my part, but it had fantastic results. So if we can come in behind him while our main force hits him from the front, I think that's what I'm going to do. Okay, I think I'm going to start up here in the north, and I'm going to start by having the furthest forces away from the enemy start moving down. Okay. Let's get Long range here. I'm gonna detach skirmishers from all of my units, all of my infantry units, and send them out. You have one cavalry unit here. Get them moving in advance of the army. A pretty good spot for artillery up here. I have you on this hill. Have you bring him up here? Hey. At 1,500 cavalry. Bring you up over here. This. Their skirmishers get out a little bit in front of them up. Even further. Are taking artillery fire down here. Ransom. Ransom up like this. $700,095 in our horse artillery. Horse artillery right up here. Yes. Like this. Okay. skirmishers. Freeze here. Start hitting the artillery right there. Doesn't look like anyone's down here. It's okay. Means we've got north. Our cavalry is moving into position down here. Here. We're pacing our skirmishers pretty good. Sure who they're firing at, but set these guys to counter battery fire. Ransom's got to start moving his forces up a little bit. Here, attachment. Thought I called all those scouts back. Alright, start bringing our brigades up. Attachment. Pulling that back. Have you come here? Have these guys. You can't dismount. There. Concentrated enough, I don't know if I really want to charge. Charging worked wonderfully. Anything just to disrupt their lines. Okay, move up into range. I have this force, whoops. Here, well, these guys hit this line right here. Turn their lines. I'm gonna take advantage of that. way to go there. Him in attack order. The battery on the end here. Skirmishers are hitting that battery. Hitting that battery. They will be hitting that battery. These guys... charge. Okay. They're coming at us. Cavalry's charging the battery back here, kind of. Take a look at the south. Here. Parent company. This is where I called in all the freshmen's. There we go. Dismounted. We're going to use these guys to kind of hold them in position. Artillery. They're firing. Up. I'm kind of hesitant to charge just because they have such a force here. This guy. Alright, looks like they drove off that artillery. I don't even see it anymore. So he can fire on the guns. simply they disappeared out of nowhere. The brigade is wavering. Taking flanking fire. They broke right there. Have these guys mount up. You guys never dismounted. Get into them. Them come up and keep these guys occupied over here. Actually, I want you to start firing on them. Breaking. Charge the guns. Have you fall back. Attachment. Really wish this attachment would be back up. I want them to. I'm not even doing anything. Okay, how are we doing up here? Let's have you dismount for now. Forward a little bit. Second Brigade wiped out. Lomax's brigade is confident. Rally. We're going to charge again. Merge into the 2nd Brigade. I'm gonna hold you out. Have you sit this charge out. You need to get in there. Your damn scouts with you. We can start turning our line to hit them over here. Anything up? They're firing. Good. Carolyn Line's nervous. Ellie. Attachment needs to go back to your parent unit. Your parent unit needs to get up here. These guys, what are they doing? It's artillery down here. These guys broke. All right, I'll back up. We are pushing them out. Back over here. Let you recover a little bit. Oh, he's breaking. Play everybody. I gotta do to get you down here. Do that, I guess. Ram. It says it's attached to him a little bit. Mounting in. Cole quit. I want you to come over here. Charging up. Oh, there's someone down here. He's broken. Chainless up over here. Call in your scouts, please. For the love of God, call in your scouts. Our detachments are starting to run low on ammo here. Have you hit? there. Third Brigade's got 1,900 with 500 casualties, so I think charging them would be a good idea. We are getting into their lines here. First Brigade. Charge. Charge. Have you charge into 3rd Brigade over here. How's his morale doing? Now he's still a pretty powerful force, so I'm not gonna. Well, he is starting to waver here. Let's have you mount. Charge. Are retreating. I'm gonna have you charge into him. Charge into him. Guys down here. I want to charge. Don't want to charge with these skirmishers. Wait a minute. Hang on. No, I don't want to charge. Really don't. Move you up a little, I guess. He just advanced right at us. First Brigade wiped out. There's another brigade that surrendered. Really don't want to charge with my skirmisher. Our cavalry down here. Yeah, why not? Charge. Charge him. How many of them we can wipe out? This is going really good. Third Brigade that's in here. amongst our troops. Hitting them as they're on their way out. Oh, they're not even on their horses. Ah, whoops. Here, mount up. Well, they were on their horse. Hit them. Oh, they're not on their horses. They're running on foot. Well, that's... Ah, damn. Charge him instead. Good damage here. 58% to 20%. Wow, that's nice. Anyone left down here? Well, they're starting to recover here. No, no, they're not. Have you halt? Hit this guy instead. Running. Oh, shit! ...60% casualties. We didn't even come close to the objective up here. Go. A major Confederate victory. They lost 40 guns. Didn't lose any. Cavalry, kind of a beating. I kind of want to see if I can... If I can figure out... A consolidated combat report. Casualties inflicted. 1st Division inflicted a lot of casualties. 3rd Brigade being... Cavalry Corps. Oh. 1,000 casualties. Brett's command. All right. Battle of Burkeville. Good for us. Confederate major victory. Let's see how they scored this one. National morale drops by 1.04. That's great. We gained 0.14 in military experience. Jones has become famous. Good job, General Jones. Glorious victory at Burkeville. Total casualties of 718 killed, 8,145 captured. Wow. We lost 3,696 with 514 killed and 597. We captured 10,000 guns. Oh, there we go. That did. 51%. Okay. Now the question is, wait, are they going to retreat? Are they going to retreat further south into my territory? Or are they going to... head north. I'd be okay if they took headed south, but play a little bit and see what happens. They're going north. All right, it's a little more we're going to have to deal with up in northern Virginia, but we are pushing them out of North Carolina. Next up, got to get our readiness set. Ransom's good. Department of Georgia and Florida and South Carolina's good. Very good. So I think what I'm going to do is got the 4th Corps out here. 1,000. These guys are going to eventually come down to retake North Carolina. We do have a lot we have to do out here still. This mess right up in here in the right south of the river. It's Fredericksburg. $12,000. That shouldn't be too bad to deal with. Pickett's coming up. Kind of hesitant to pull anyone out of the Richmond area, but we're going to have to deal with this. We've got these forces out here, plus I could click on them. 11,000. They've got 1,500. Not entirely sure we're going to take that. But we're working on it. We're working on it. We're going to save that for the next episode. If we can get these guys out and push them up, we can stand a chance of retaking Alexandria. Winchester is already almost in our possession. Get these guys up and then move up towards Washington. Probably going to move Lee and Longstreet both up Brewery's Bluff Garrison. Anyway, we're going to deal with that in the next episode. If you like this one, hit the like button. If you want to follow along through our campaign, hit the subscribe. If you have any thoughts, tips, or advice, leave those in the comment section below, and we will see you back in 1864. J76NY saying thank you very much for watching, and have yourself a very good day.